Hello and welcome to another video from UNM.NU. That's the University of New Money. And so today's topic is stock-to-flow ratio. For those of you who are not aware of what a stock-to-flow ratio, that is the stock of a commodity, or in this case Bitcoin, to the flow, which is the amount of Bitcoin or commodity which is created in a given year. Now, the reason that is so important to gold and Bitcoin is while gold has been around for thousands of years and Bitcoin's only been around for about 11 years, is the principle of stock to flow is very important in terms of economics, in that if a commodity is very easy to uncover from the earth or process, then if the price of a commodity goes up, what's going to happen is that a lot of people are just going to produce more of that commodity until prices return to stabilized prices. However, gold is very difficult to mine from the earth, and so it has the best stock to flow in the history of the world. In fact, according to this article, gold stock to flow ratio is 58.3. Well, after the Bitcoin halving, which took place May 11, 2020, when the Bitcoin reward was reduced from 12.5 to 6.25, it would take 56 years to replace every Bitcoin in circulation, making the stock-to-flow ratio of Bitcoin very comparable to gold. That is why a lot of times you'll hear Bitcoin referred to as digital gold among other attributes that they share in common. Now, why is stock to flow so important? Again, if the commodity is very easy to replicate or to extract from the earth, it can devalue the currency or the commodity. With Bitcoin reducing its reward in half and improving its stock to flow ratio, that is only going to increase the value of Bitcoin. I expect gold and Bitcoin to perform very well the rest of 2020 and beyond, especially as the U.S. government is printing trillions of dollars and the world is experiencing turmoil economically. We're seeing fiat currencies really put to the test right now. The problem with fiat currencies is they can just print as much money as they want, and so far we've been okay, but this is early on in this global crisis. And so eventually you would expect that printing unlimited amounts of money would catch up to these countries. What is the solution to that? Gold is an excellent solution which has stood the test of time, but what is a better solution? Bitcoin. I'm a huge fan of Bitcoin. I believe gold has its benefits as it's tangible. You can turn it into jewelry. But Bitcoin being constrained to computer code, the fact that you could transfer it anywhere around the world for very small transaction costs within about 10 minutes, and other applications of Bitcoin are just going to make Bitcoin such an amazing investment from here on out. So I hope that understanding and learning about stock to flow has helped you today. I hope it's encouraged you to invest in Bitcoin. Remember only to invest what you're willing to lose, but I believe this is an amazing investment from here on out. And this article, which talks about stock to flow, supports that. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel, please subscribe to receive all notifications of upcoming videos. And if you haven't visited the website, please visit unm.nu and feel free to respond to this video or to forum posts, as I like to communicate with all of you. I'm always willing to take requests for upcoming videos and to get ideas of what you think about Bitcoin and the cryptocurrency industry. Y'all take care and we'll be in touch. Goodbye.